Who is Jesus? 2. Is Jesus God incarnate or a man who has received a special gift? Is Jesus God incarnate or a man who has received special gifts from God? Well, I would say that the thesis that says he is a man who has received special gifts from God is the Muslim thesis. So 7 centuries later, Muslims say, Christians so loved Jesus, so admired his preaching and his work that they eventually magnified his facts and made him a god. But they say, Jesus never said he was God. What they are wrong about. The text of the Gospel says the opposite. Mohammed is more precise. He says the text, as a result, has been falsified. Well, it must be said that all Christians, all present Christians, except Jehovah's Witnesses, claim that Jesus Christ is not a man. He is the eternal Word of God, who became flesh. He relies on this, to say that in the Scripture which without any ambiguity, for example at all the Gospel according to St. John says this, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word, that means the knowledge, the plenary light of God, the Word was God and the Word was with God, which seems to indicate that in God there are two things, the Word and God. We know that Christians have always believed that it was one God. It is from there that the dogmatic definition of the Trinity will come later. And the Word continues the Gospel according to St. John, and the Word became flesh and we have seen his glory, which he holds from the Father, as the only begotten Son. This Word made flesh is Jesus. Some have claimed that the deity of Jesus was an invention of St. Paul. Well, the text I just quoted shows that this is false. It is first in the Gospel according to St. John that it is affirmed in length and breadth. And even at a given moment, Jesus attributes to himself the name of Yahweh, to the point that the Jews question him and ask him, "Who are you?" "Before Abraham was," replies Jesus, "I am." And then they want to stone him. Jesus asks them, "For what work do you want to stone me?" And they answer, "It is not for a work, it is because you who are only a man you make you God." Which shows that at one point, his language was clear on that fact. Of course, St. Paul also confirms the divinity of Jesus and St. Paul did not know Jesus during his lifetime. He appeared to him after his resurrection on the road to Damascus. St. Paul writes, "Jesus, of divine condition, did not jealously hold the rank that equaled him to God. But he has annihilated himself as a man, a servant on earth." So the consequence is that the first dogma and indeed the truth affirmed by the Church, which is fundamental, is that Jesus Christ is not a man, it is God who became man.